let's construct a biodigester and have it connected to a gutter or a wastewater drainage or causeway. And that's exactly what I'm going to show you in this video. On this channel, we do videos that explain how biodigesters work and how you can use them as an option to manage all your human waste in your dream house. So basically, whenever you do construct a biodigester, you have three options. Your first option is to have it connected to a soak-away pit or a simple on-site soak-away. The second option is to have a traditional soak-away constructed for the biodigester. And the third option is to have it connected to a gutter or simply a wastewater drainage system. And that's exactly what we are going to do for this video by choosing the third option. So basically what we have started with is to have the ground dug. You need to do your digging, which is the usual thing. And then you need to have the place that you are going to connect the pipe to. That's the leche pipe. So that's what we have started with in this video. You do the digging first and get your everything sorted out. That means that you are going to have to get a leche pipe out of the digester into the causeway. So the doing the digester and then having the leche pipe outside of it, connecting it into the gutter, is what is going to make the digester work. Don't forget the biodigester simply works because there's no wastewater retaining in the digester. It is not a holding tank, and it is just that the biodegradation only happens when you do have no less than any water, no amount of water in the digester. So for us, we are using a 3-inch pipe and we are connecting it to the gutter by giving it a slope, and then we're letting the water out immediately. You flush, the water must go out of the digester. Since we are using prefabricated slab, this digester is being done for a security post. So we are going to just use the simple on-site slabs, the standard family size slabs that we do have prefabricated already. And we are going to have the inlet there. It's only one toilet. And then as well as having the outlet showing. What we are doing is, because the ground is not that good, that's the main reason why we actually even didn't do a soak away for this, because we have to let the water go. We put some small chippings at the base of the screeding before the screeding is done, so that at least it helps make the mortar very strong when you do it, sort of concrete mixture whenever it's done and it's ready. So that's exactly what we are doing, selling all the metal joints, which is key for you when you are doing biodigester using the prefabricated slabs. First, tighten the binding wires that are already fixed there, and then having the mortar joints sealed the whole place up to make sure that your digester is airtight. The right amount of mixture of mortar will make sure that this digester works to perfection for you when you do have it constructed. What you also need to understand is that these digesters only work because they do not produce biogas. These are not digesters that have made with biogas as an output. They are only digesters that are simply on site by the biodegradable toilets. You do not do anything else apart from that. That's the only thing they do. They do not produce gas for domestic use or for commercial purposes. And these digesters are actually not new. The digesters that have been in the system over a decade here in Ghana, and homeowners have been using it, helping them manage their solid waste and human waste in their backyard. You have to make sure your inlet pipe is connected, and then seal it with the mortar. Put an end cap on it, because what it also means is that it's not going to be done now. When the plumber comes, he only takes out the end cap and then fix the toilet seats, and then do the pipe from the inside the house straight into the inlet pipe that you are leaving for him to use. The inlet is based on the pipes that are coming from the house. So if you do have a pipe that is coming from inside the house, the 4-inch pipes, that's are the pipe that you look out for. Then you do the inlet as an inlet hole. So in our case, what we are going to do is to just do it and put a pipe there and have an end cap on it. Then when the plumber who will be coming to do the connection, he will come and then he will join it. When he terminates the pipe, he will join it to our already connected pipe to the biodigester. You have to tighten the slabs. What we do is, when we do cast the slabs, we have some binding wires that we attach them
So you need the clippers to hold them firm and then tighten them so that they do not, so that they are not loose and they be stay firm, followed by giving it a mortar joint just to make sure that it is firm. That's key for you. You do the four side corners of them and then you hold them firmly together. The prefabricated slabs are usually done with wire mesh and some quarry dust and only cement. You do not add sand to them so that they become firm and then they can hold the digester or the solid when it comes in. In this situation, what we are also doing is to make sure that the square that we are using is the work in terms of the slabs, they've been done well. All the four corners have to be tested to make sure that when the top cover comes on it, they fit perfectly and there are no holes left by the side. That's key for you in this situation.
When you have done all the joints, including the electric pipe, has been sealed with mortar joints, leaving the hole that goes straight out into the gutter or the drainage system, you will do the screening and the base of the biodigester, giving the slope to where the electric pipe is going to the drainage system. When you do that, what it means is that you are giving it that slope that any water that comes into the digester will simply go out of it straight through the electric pipe into the drainage system. Or you also need to make sure that you are doing the right filtration, because you do not want solid waste to pass through that pipe into the gutter. You are going to get fined for it if anybody sees the solid waste. If authorities see solid waste in the drainage system, one of the advice is to make sure that you are using enough coconut husk. You are adding a lot of filtration materials like coconut husk on top of the digester bed after putting the prefabricated slab on it, and then adding the coconut husk or the coconut fiber on it and making sure that it's covered all the grounds all around it. And then from there, you can sew the biodigester and then do all the nicely mortar works that you need to do by finishing it up nicely and doing nice plastering to make sure that the digester looks standard for whoever you are doing it for. That's exactly what we did for this biodigester, and this is the end product. On this channel, we do videos that explain how biodigesters work and how you can use them as an option to manage all your human waste in your dream house. This video I'm next showing on this channel is going to explain to you how biodigesters work and how you can use it to manage your solid waste in your own house.